Hey friends, we are continuing our ASP.NET Core 101 video series. In the last video, we made a very, very simple web API that was really kind of showing how one could make a web API, but I'm not feeling too proud of it.
Yeah, it's not the most ideal way to go about it.
Yeah, it's not the most ideal way, but it showed us a bit of plumbing, a bit of the internals of ASP.NET, and we ended up doing it in basically three lines in startup. Leslie's kind of feeling gross about it. I'm kind of feeling gross about it. And it's not bad. We're teasing each other a little bit here. But the point is, that's if you do it manually. Let's not do it that way, shall we?
Yeah.
All right.
Why don't we separate all this stuff out into its own separate spot?
Right. Because we've been talking about the need for a single responsibility principle, mm-hmm. or what they call that, separation of concerns.
Yeah.
And then we did this horrible thing.
Yeah. Right? We've got to practice what we preach.
Yeah. So I want to comment that out. I'm going to say Control K, Control C. Look at that.
Awesome.
Comment that out so we no longer have a web API.
Mm-hmm.
Earlier, you made me make a models folder, and that's where we're currently keeping things. And pages are kind of views. So we've got models and views.
Yeah, so I guess all that's missing is the controller.
Right.
For those of you familiar with MVC or Model View Controller.
Right. ASP.NET is a very flexible web framework. You can make APIs. You can make Model View Controller type things. You can make just pages with a page model. And you can mix and match them all. It's not it's not really prescriptive. You can do what makes you happy.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's do that. So I'll just make a folder if that's okay.
Yep.
Add new folder. Controllers. Is that cool?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And then we can call the new file product controllers.
Okay, so I'm going to say
or products add controller.
Controller products, plural.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Ah, this is interesting. So when I said add controller, I could have said add class.
Yeah.
But I said add controller, and they're giving me a little bit more feedback here. I could make an empty API controller. I think that'd probably work for our needs.
Yeah, that sounds about right since we're enhancing our API.
Okay. So we'll say add, and then we'll say a products controller, plural. That's going to go and scaffold that out. It's going to kind of create that. Just take a moment.
Mm-hmm.
And when we create this, we're going to have the products model and the products controller.
So why even have MVC? Like, what's the point?
That is a good question. And the idea is that in separation of concerns, you want to have the model that knows how to talk to the database. You want to have the controller that is your orchestrator that has left hand in the database and right hand in the views. And then your views, and views know nothing about anything. They only know about how to display information, display data.
And again, that's great because it's like the whole ignorance is bliss for code. If you want to reuse this stuff or expand on it later,
mm-hmm.
it's a lot easier to do that if you don't have so many dependencies between.
You know, you said that before, that idea of ignorance is bliss. And let's make sure that that's a joke that people get, because it really makes sense, though. If your object knows nothing about anything other than its one job,
mm-hmm.
it's a much more useful object.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if your object knows all about the internet, and then, I don't know, the internet goes away, who knows what happens?
I don't know. But the problem is, if it knows everything, you end up with these giant monolith classes that you've probably seen before. You probably made one before if you're not new to programming itself, and then you kind of regret it later when you try to find or do anything else with that later.
Exactly. So we just created a products controller, and products controller has this controller base that it derives from. It inherits behaviors from controller base, so it can do stuff that controller base can do.
Again, that was nice of Visual Studio. It did all this for us, so we didn't have to figure out what we needed to be extending.
Right.
From.
When we made a new controller, we got this for free.
Yeah.
It is an API controller, and it meets a certain route, mm-hmm. and we will figure out how to plug these things in. But right now, it doesn't really do anything. We could have made one that did more stuff, but that's fine.
Yeah. So speaking of making it do stuff, mm-hmm. maybe we should add.
Make it do some stuff.
Yeah.
Now, in this case here, they've got us putting it at API/controller. This is products. I kind of want it to just stay at products. So if it's
fair
cool
enough.
With you, I will delete that. Because it could be foo/bar/products.
Yeah, you can create whatever crazy route you want.
Yep. And I want our route to be like super basic, right?
Yep.
If that's okay. And then we're going to make a constructor because it needs to construct things, right?
Yes.
So what are we called here? Products controller. And I'll just make a regular default one.
Mm-hmm.
But,
You know that service that we made a while ago? It was like JSON file.
Yep, JSON file product service. That's where our products come from. We're going to need one of those.
Yeah, maybe we should take advantage of that.
Right. So we could new one, we could make one in the old days, but no, we're using the services technique that is available to us in ASP.NET. So we don't actually new them. We don't go var j equals new. Instead, we just ask for them, and we ask for them by adding them to our constructor. And we can ask, remember the logging? We can add logging. If you take a look at one of our previous videos, we had logging. This controller could have that as well.
That's great.
That's cool. And then we need to hold it somewhere, have it lying around somewhere. So we'll go and say JSON file product service, and then we need to be able to get that, you know, whenever.
Yeah, we don't need to modify it right now either.
Okay. So. And then we'll say this product service equals that product service. So when, well, who makes controllers, right? I mean, we don't. ASP.NET just makes them. There's a controller factory, in fact.
Ooh.
Yeah, the controller factory. Every time you make a call, the controller factory says, you got any product controllers? Oh, what does a product controller need? It needs these services. It needs logging. It needs JSON file product service. Wires it all up and says, here, made
going
it
back
for
to
you.
Design patterns days.
It is. Yes, it's exactly what it is. It is a nice design pattern. That is our basic thing here. Before, when we did a page, you and I were doing Razor pages, in the code behind, we said on get. Mm-hmm. And there's a similar kind of a model if you're going to do things with controllers, isn't there?
Yeah. I believe it has to do with like HTTP. So you have HTTP post or get. Let's use get in this case. Maybe.
Yep. That's exactly right. So we're going to make a method that returns product. Again, I'm going to hit control dot. The control dot pops up that menu.
Yep.
And we're going to do get. And to your point, it will be an HTTP. Look at that. There's a
awesome.
List of all
so
the
many
verbs.
Options.
Right. So I can pick some of the more obscure verbs. We'll use some of the more obscure ones a little bit later.
Mm-hmm.
When people get stuff, call get, cool. Notice how it's kind of threatening me right now. Hey, not all paths return a value.
You're not returning anything.
In fact, nothing is happening, right? All right, well, where do products live? In the service.
Probably that service, yeah.
Return.
Product service.
Okay. Dot
get products.
Cool. Let's compare these for a second. So this is a nice, clean controller with a lot of flexibility. I can change the route. It doesn't really know anything about anything.
No.
It just does one job. It is a broker.
That's pretty great.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's compare that to what we did before.
Ugh, so much nicer. Notice all those bajillion function calls happening in just that first line alone.
Mm-hmm.
It's really messy and not
There's a lot going on here. We're digging around. We went digging for our service, and we went manually serializing. This is a great point here. This line here where we called the JSON serializer ourselves, we didn't even mention JSON.
Yeah, because we already put it in that product service.
Let's see if it works, though. Here we are complimenting each other,
yeah.
but we don't know, right, if it doesn't work,
somehow
that would be bad. Let's give it a try. So we'll
we're
run
not
it
all
again.
Talk.
Yeah, we are all talk. Who knows? Products.
Well,
I have a thought. I bet you it's capital P. No. Interesting. Let's go find out what's going on. Did we tell ASP.NET that controllers are a thing, even?
You know, I don't think we did. Maybe we shouldn't neglect that startup file after all.
That's what you get when we're talking smack, trying to compliment each other.
Talking a good game.
Well, we mentioned before that our application uses routing and uses endpoints. We added that JSON file product service, but we didn't tell it about controllers.
Yeah, sorry, startup. So let's tell them. So let's go back down to we already commented that stuff out. So why don't we add a controller service under the configure service method?
So services.add. Now we can add the entire MVC, like everything, views and controllers and like the whole kind of thing. But instead, let's just go and add controllers. You only want to add the stuff you're going to use.
Yeah.
Maybe later we'll add other stuff. But for now,
keep it minimal.
Keep it minimal, exactly. So this is a very common pattern. You add stuff. And then you use stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So back under the endpoints land, we're going to add another endpoint. We're going to map to our controller.
So we're going to say map controllers. Interesting. So we've got, remember how we talked about this, Razor pages, /privacy/error.
Yep.
Controllers, you can't see it, but it will be /products because we routed it as /products. products, because that's the name of our controller. Mm-hmm. And again, worth pointing out, we could always say slash foo or whatever if we felt like it.
Now, in this case, we've been getting JSON this whole time with this API that we made. But like, what if we didn't want JSON? Could we swap to like XML or something?
That is a very good point. So right now, it's assuming that I'm just going to return a list of products, but it doesn't say as what. Do we want the products controller to be responsible for that? Maybe we would want to configure that, because it's, you have to ask yourself, is that a business problem or is that more of a check a box maybe problem? You can, if you want, go check out the docs and learn about how to add XML serializers to this and teach it how to automatically return XML. And the cool part is no code would change in the controller.
That is excellent.
Isn't that fun? All right. Now do we think it will work?
I think it'll work. Pressure, I feel good about this.
Pressure's on. I don't know. Okay, I just hit Control F5. I'm going to go ahead and run that.
Right.
I'm going to hit slash products.
Yay!
There we go. Now we're back in business. TCB.
Yep.
Fantastic.
I actually don't know what that stands for.
Taking care of business.
Fail.
We're TCBing here doing ASP.NET Core. Let's take a break, and we'll come back, and we'll extend that service with not just a GET, but with something else.
Cool. TTYL.